Oi, Justin, it's time to investigate a murder most foul.
Oh, yeah, murder again in London town. Fish and chips.
Sure. Why don't you take the lead on this video? Because this is your fetish that we're analyzing.
I don't think fetish is accurate.
I think fetish is accurate, actually.
Sherlock Holmes is back in Chevin. This is the seventh Frogwares Sherlock Holmes game. It follows Testament of Sherlock Holmes, and it's called Sherlock Holmes Crimes and Punishments.
Where do you think it all started with you, your whole situation?
I went to a demo for Sherlock Holmes, the Testament of Sherlock Holmes, Shix, the sixth Sherlock Holmes game, and the demo was so bizarre that I kind of got wrapped up in the world.
From what I understand, though, Chevin is actually not a bad game.
Crimes and Punishments, Chevin, is not a bad game. It's actually quite a good game. I liked it a lot.
Let
me tell you what's going to go on here. He's investigating this murder, but he's checking this dude out, and he's using his special Sherlock observational skills.
I dig this because this is like the show to me, which is probably the Sherlock canon I'm most familiar with.
It's taking some like cues from that, certainly, both in Sherlock's personality, which sort of has a little bit of that sociopath edge, and some of his like hyper, overlaying the observations he makes into the world to kind of like make you feel like you're Sherlock. So in these, when
are you going for his penis?
I'm going to check out the penis, see what he's working with. No, I checked out these things, and this gives me a clearer picture of who he is. And then as I'm investigating him, I can use those facts that I picked up about him, that he's fastidious, that he lives alone, that he delivered a telegram today. I can use those to sort of catch him up in a lie and get more facts about the case. In this case, someone has been murdered in this this bathhouse, and Sherlock is on the case to investigate it.
Okay. Watson. Is that a new look for him? Is the mustache seems thicker this year? It seems a little bit
pushy. It is a thick mustache year for him. We've moved to Unreal Engine 3.
Oh, I see.
For this Sherlock game, so they're able to have more mustache depth.
One of the things I've heard you talk about, you talked about this, I think, on the bombcast we did, is that there's never a clear solution for the cases. Like, when you finish a case, you don't know whether or not you got it right.
Yeah, we actually, there's some part of the video that will relate to that in a little bit, so let's hold off on talking about that until we get there, because I think it's hard to visualize.
Okay.
Otherwise, this is the opening moment, so like, when you're first on the scene, it's very much about just getting the information and collecting sort of some details. So you'll see, just like that pop up. Oh, that's something I need to check out. Anytime you see a magnifying glass, that's an opportunity for you to get some details.
Do you have his whole eyeball.
The whole eyeball clean out.
Do you have like a special clue vision that highlights that stuff in the world?
So most of the clues you can just sort of find by yourself. There are some that require Sherlock to focus a little more and see things that average people will miss. There's a moment where you'll see that.
You are just really looking at, really enjoying that body right now.
I'm savoring it. So he's dead.
Nah.
Dead as disco. But I think there might be something else going on here. So I check out the face. Okay, face is looking good. He's got a wound. Get these details. Watson has to chime in, because he's a doctor and he never wants to let anybody forget it. Some clues.
He has a ring.
Here. He did.
I'm a regular Sherlock myself, aren't I?
Yeah, you're a junior Sherlock. You see anything else you think I should look at?
His nails look real grody.
Grody nails? I don't know. How about the wrist?
The wrist looks fine to me. There's no clues there.
Uh-oh. Recent death. You would have missed that.
I would have missed that.
You would have missed that entirely. But maybe You were right.
Oh boy,
Dirty Nails getting a sample. So you'll take once you've actually collected the clues, there are some like investigative type activities you can partake in back in the lab at Baker Street that are basically like science experiments that you do on these things to that uncover more clues.
You pour baking soda and vinegar over the ring.
In this one, you find a coin. In this particular case, you find a coin and a lump of silver, and you want to compare the silver content in them. So you have to get a pipette and put acid on them. And the actual command it offers you is drop acid when you actually do that. It's like, well, I don't think that means exactly what you think it means, Sherlock, but okay.
Might help with his deduction. Maybe it'll refill his focus meter or something.
You know, previously there have been focus has actually been a renewable resource that would like refill over time. Here you can do it whenever you want to. So you're going to get an example of that now.
There's a key.
You don't see that. You're not a regular person.
Shit.
You're just an average Joe. You don't see that. But Sherlock presses R1 to activate his Sherlock vision. And then he sees the key.
I swear to God, I saw it though.
No, you didn't. You thought you did, but you didn't. And you'll use that, and that key is like, huh, that's interesting. I wonder what that key's all about. Now, here you see some men that are disturbed, I think, by the events.
But that has not scared them out of the steam room.
Well, they're not allowed to leave.
Oh, I see. That seems dangerous to keep them in there because they could die.
Yeah. Until I've given the order, they're not allowed to.
But you're not supposed to spend more than like 15 minutes in those places, or else you'll die instantly.
This is old timey England. We didn't know about stuff like that.
Shit.
We didn't have that information.
We lost so many good people.
Now, if you want to talk about bad clues, look at this from this guy's towel. That doesn't look so good for you, sir. We'll be talking about that later. I assure you.
I don't trust Mr. Blinkhorn. Actually, looking at
you. Ready? There's an Easter egg coming up.
Uh oh.
Check out that plate.
Oh, come on, guys. Oh, come on. Come on, guys. Guys, come on, guys. Guys. Guys, come on. Please.
I'm into it. Whatever. I don't care. I'm a dad now. I love stuff like that.
I know you do, but come on, please.
I can fill the room with steam if I want, and then use my Sherlock vision to navigate it.
Okay.
I decided not to do that, because I know nothing comes of it, so I don't do that.
Wow. You're prescient now.
Yeah. And I played this case before, so yeah. How many people have keys to the steam room? So I went to grill this cat. Now, do you remember some of how we got the information from him earlier, right?
Right. You scoped out the...
Scoped out his whole situation, all of his little... Now, that is going to be useful here in a second. You're going to see this. Watch.
No, sir. I did not.
Oh, really? Because square button. I know you sent a telegram because I saw you with it. Burn. Mr. Phillips.
And he's going to get real freaked out. Like, you're in my brain. You're in my cabeza.
Yeah. It actually is a pretty amazing 180 on lying about it. Check this. Telegram was for someone in Manchester. Mr. Holmes, it's important. Ah, screw it. All right. Ah, damn it.
They hadn't really invented lying yet in London at this time.
The truth is actually worse. Look at what he did. Close the baths on my
way out. Yeah, just lock him right in there, I guess. From your sister?
No, she wasn't meant to. I just told her to pawn my old school uniform so that she could pay for the medication.
Apparently there's like a secondhand market for school uniforms, because she pawned his old school uniform to buy medicine for his old ma. Congratulations, Sherlock, you really busted this thug.
Yeah, can you ease off of him, actually?
Yeah, can you just like pump the brakes? So now we're in Scotland Yard, teleported Scotland Yard. And we're taking a closer look at, this is like some of the hard evidence type stuff. This is actually in the evidence room in Scotland Yard. So you can go over,
forget that pencil. Okay.
Forget that pencil.
It's normal.
It's just a normal pencil. Oh, really? This is the definition of red herring, bloody towel. And then a file of drugs. Do you think it was that guy?
No, I'm telling you, it was that one dude with the bald spot.
So these are all useful for, you know, you're going to interrogate those cats. And if you've seen these clues, if you've seen this stuff, then you'll be able to use this information against them. Some of it's just like looking at the stuff and getting the information out of it, right? So, you know, you see he has a handkerchief there. Okay, good to know.
That pin was that pin was the murder weapon. I know it.
This was the guy who was killed. This is his stuff. So, he didn't. Or no. This is another cat. This is the guy who runs the bathhouse.
Just go ahead and put that down. There's no clues there.
Or is there a visiting card? Apparently, that's a thing. I don't know about it.
It's been a while since we've been to a steam house.
Right. This is the guy who was killed, Bentcliffe. Rodney Bentcliffe. He sounds like somebody who's begging to be murdered, honestly.
Yeah.
Oh, what's that?
There are pages missing. I found it. Slylock Fox.
Wait. Please prevent anyone
from entering the room. Oh, get that ordinary pencil. We're going
to... Yeah, you remember that from... Or it was an ordinary pencil, but we're going to use it for sinister purposes. This is like the most realistic moment I've ever seen in any sort of mystery game, right? So, Sherlock... not this part. This is insane. It would never happen in a bajillion years. But basically, you know, it's that old, like, oh, there's a faint mark here, so let's scratch over with a pencil and then smudge it. I'm doing this all by hand, by the way. This is it's a shame I was playing on PS4. There's no Kinect functionality to enjoy with this interaction.
Is that true? Is that a real
thing? But check this out. Oh, you cut it. My name is Sherlock. A guy comes in and is like, what are you doing? And Sherlock Holmes is like, well, I'm Sherlock Holmes. I can do what I want. don't get off my case. You're destroying evidence. Nah, not me. So this is just the little guy with the bloody towel and the file. And again, you see the square button down there that allows me to check for deets, check his situation out.
His situation's pretty sweaty. I see.
I do this whenever I'm trolling for guys at the bar too. Yeah. This is the first thing I do.
He's got rivulets of sweat. Yeah.
Yeah. Not looking great for him right now. And
can you just like his clothes are shitty? Is that like
yeah, dirty clothes? Okay. There. And then look, some kind of crazy protective amulet. Like not liking this dude as a normal person, but as a like a murderer, like. Pretty good right now. I do like his odds.
So if there's no murder, if there's no like definitive like answer to these, can you just be like, you look at your crazy amulet,
look at your crazy stuff,
put him in the gallows, he's done.
So this is the weird thing about it, right? So once you've collected all this information, you get a lot of like facts, just like regular facts, and with a button press you're able to go into Sherlock's cortex, into his brain, with all these facts that you have,
okay,
and look for a connection between them. So you see Sir Rodney lied about something. Is that related to anything? Well, it's not related to that. I wasn't really paying that close attention right now, but okay, I made a connection, and what that does is it creates a synapse in Sherlock's brain, like this is something I know, and that leads to something else. As with some of them, when you draw a connection between two facts that you've created, the synapse that it'll create in Sherlock's brain has two parts to it. It'll have two separate sections, and with that, it's two different interpretations of the same fact. So, yeah, if their fight either meant that Blinkhorn hated the guy or Blinkhorn loved the guy. And it's really, that is the kind of thing that is like up to how you interpret the facts. And you can see that little line growing out of there.
Yeah.
As you collect more things and make more decisions, those will grow in and make connections until you've basically built a case. But the case that was built is based mainly on how you have interpreted the facts and how you've interpreted the
You're just guessing right
just
now.
Just blindly
right?
guessing.
Okay,
now.
Great.
That is an option.
There's no penalty. You won't like develop an aneurysm in your mind palace and just keel over.
Is Sherlock having a stroke? No, I'm making connections.
Oh, the champagne is in the brazier. What are you saying? The drug are in the notes. The drug are in the notes?
Steam moisture. It either means something or it doesn't. And that's up to you. But after you've made it, that it leads to a deduction. Or in some cases, it can lead to more things that you have to do. So one connection might mean like an activity that you aren't sure about it, so you need to do further research to see if you can recreate something. Sometimes it's like, I don't know if a single man it would be strong enough to throw a harpoon through this guy, so I'm going to go down to the butcher shop and throw harpoons at pigs. Okay. And it's a mini game.
I'm into that.
But the deduction that you make, Mr. Holmes, is what you're doing. Yours. I mean, you can make whatever deduction you want, and you never have to know if you got it right or not. That's not, it's not something you have to worry about.
Yeah.
This is the bummer. There is a right answer.
You just don't know if you got it.
You just don't know if you got it, but you can check and see. But it tells you not to, because you'll spoil the game for yourself. I wish they'd just taken that option out, because it's hard to resist. And some of these are based on Conan Doyle cases, so... the answer is set, especially if you know the work. But it's really interesting. I thought it was really fun. After you've decided on the criminal, you actually also get to decide if you should go after him or let him get away. Maybe it was justified in your opinion, you know, and you have a set ending for each of those solutions, and it's completely up to you. However you do it, it is the ending you get.
Cool. Well, this is Chevin. Thank you.
Sherlock Holmes, Crimes and Punishments.
Thank you, Justin. Thank you, Sherlock. Thank you, Frogwares. Thank you, viewer, for watching. We'll see you later.
Bye. Badly too, with silver.